The James Madison Dukes went into Delaware Stadium, a very difficult place to play, and in their final possession came away with a 24-21 victory. Hello, everyone. I'm Kurt Dudley. Welcome in to the Coach Everett Withers Show as we talk James Madison University Dukes football with the head coach, Everett Withers. Game number 10 is in the books. The Dukes are now 8-2, an important eighth victory. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. But, Coach, in a game in which it came down to James Madison's final possession, getting a big stop on a third down play, it was set up, really, by the special teams all the way back in the first quarter, in fact, as some pressure that was applied on the punting unit for the Delaware Blue Hens, and that resulted in, ultimately, a short field for you in the game-winning drive.
Well, yeah, Kurt, we did a nice job early in the game getting some pressure. We thought we could. We kind of figured out what they were doing in their punt protection, and we thought we could get some pressure. And I think Brendan Ravenel obviously caught the winning touchdown. We felt like he got a hand on the first one that we went after, got a little bit of it. And we felt like we wanted to put that same pressure again if we got him stopped on third down there late in the game and see if we could get either a block or a shank, and we ended up getting the second. So they worked well for us.
I must confess, I must be honest, that with about 2.5 to go, they picked up a big first down, right. And I thought the way that they were running down the clock, that there was a good chance that was going to ice the game. But the Dukes never quit. Right. Take us through that last series, though, defensively, because you were faced with a third down and four, and Joe Walker, their quarterback, comes a yard shy. What happened there?
Well, I'll take you even further back. Okay. When they got the first down and it was two whatever left in the game, you know, using timeouts was real important. We had two left, and I wanted to be able to use those timeouts there, and we got them stopped on first down, got them stopped on second down. We knew coming up on third down the way the wind was going and the way the weather was that they were going to put it in their quarterback's hands to win the game, and our kids all knew that, and they did a nice job of getting them stopped on third down. I think our guys, you know, rose to the occasion, and then obviously we go after the punt and get good field position to set up the winning drive.
Yeah, Raven Green was credited with the tackle that comes just the yard shy, and that punt only goes 5 yards, so you get the ball at your own 49-yard line. Can you go ahead and take us now through that game-winning series?
Yeah, well, we were in position, and you know, with the time left on the clock, our offense moved so fast, so it wasn't going to be like we were going to be in any kind of hurry-up mode. We were in our normal mode, so we didn't execute on a number of plays. We hit probably more explosive plays in that drive than we did the entire game.
Yes.
And that was big for us. And then obviously getting the big throw over to Rashad, and then the game winner at the end was really big for us.
Yeah, you had the Rashad Davis. That was a 23-yarder on the first play. And then a nice little pass. Just the way it kind of developed there with Khalid Abdul coming out of the backfield. Yep. I haven't seen that play recently. Was that just something that was newly executed?
No, I think what had happened was Brian did a really good job of finding his check down.
Okay.
And that's really what it was. It was a check down. They were sinking real deep in coverage, trying to take away some of the deep routes. And he was able to hit Khalid out there, and Khalid did a nice job of taking the ball down the sideline and getting us in real good position.
It ended up being a third and 10 at the 12-yard line. You did try a couple of other cracks at it there. You know, the one throw, I think, that the Dukes just did miss in the end zone was a good pass by Shore. Because the only guy who was going to catch it was going to be the receiver.
Right. They did a nice job of defending some of our deep balls. And we had an opportunity to make one catch. We didn't come up with it. But I think, you know, as the game went down, he felt really comfortable with throwing the ball over to Brandon late in the game.
Yeah, Brandon Ravel comes up with comes up with the touchdown reception for the game winner. Both teams open up by scoring on their initial drives. Both teams get real long runs on the initial drive. JMU gets the Cardon Johnson 48-yard touchdown run. Prior to that, Delaware gets a 63-yard run and setting up for a short play. But after that, Coach, neither team had any more explosive running plays.
Well, it turned into a game of field position because I think of the wind and the weather. I think their whole motive going into the game was to keep the ball. If you noticed, and I'm sure the football novice noticed, they never broke the huddle until the clock was down to about 18 seconds.
Yes.
And they were in four-minute mode the entire game. In fact, right before half, they don't even try to score. They were happy going into the locker room being 7-7. So I think the big thing was for us is to try to play a field position game with our kicking game, and we were able to give them a long field most of the night, and we felt like if we did that, we would eventually be a, you know, able to score late in the game.
Well, there's always the three aspects of the game, offense, defense, and special teams. And if there's a unit that you can point to that won that ball game for you, take away, of course, the final drive. But the special teams throughout the game, and it goes to your special teams player of the week. What a great game he had.
Right. Gunnar Kane did an unbelievable job. He had a 42 net on his punts. He had five punts inside the 20. And he did an unbelievable job of placing the ball where we needed it. And again, our most of our coverage units, I felt all of our coverage units did a really nice job in the entire game. And then obviously our punt block team did a great job.
What I thought was so impressive was that three of his balls that were not dropped down inside the 5 yard line, all of those were into that very strong wind. How does he do that?
Well, you know, if you go back a year ago, we struggled at doing that. And I think it was one of the aspects we put on his checklist for the offseason. He did an unbelievable job of working on it all summer long. And he's had some tremendous success putting the punch down inside the 20 and even inside the 10 and the 5 at times. So hats off to Gunnar for working on something that was a weakness that he enhanced and made better.
Yeah, he's been 21 times. He's only punted the ball 31 times. And, you know, here's a guy that you really don't want to have out on the field,
right.
You know, quite
right.
frankly.
Right.
But he has performed excessively well there for you. Cardin Johnson, I thought he had really a very good physical game because they were trying to bottle it up the middle. But yet you continue to say, Cardin, carry the load. Let's go ahead. And you wanted to stay with the inside run, even though they're pretty good with the inside run.
Yeah, they were big and physical inside, and they really did a nice job of really pinching and taking away the inside run lanes. But we felt like we had to keep going and keep trying to emphasize the inside run game because that was going to help us down the road with throwing the ball and with the perimeter run game. So we had to stay with it, and Cardin did an unbelievable job. 98 yards net rushing, you know, to do that versus what they were trying to stop was pretty impressive.
Now, the weather, it was extremely windy. I didn't get the actual wind gauge, but it was in your face for two quarters, just the way it was blowing down there at Delaware Stadium. Coach, when you have a game like that, you talk about you're taking offensively what teams give you defensively.
Sure.
Well, what can you take when Mother Nature isn't giving you things, you know? What do you do there?
Well, what you try to do is you try to get the win and you try to make your plays when you have the win. And you have to understand when they have the win, they're going to try to make their plays too. So, you know, you go into quarters where you know you're not going to get a lot of deep balls, so you got to stop the run on defense.
Mm-hmm.
And really, to be honest with you, playing Delaware, it was stop the run all four quarters. They did not want to throw the ball and turn the ball over, even though they had three turnovers. And I think that was a big part of the game. If you look at the game, you look at special teams and turnovers. I think that was a big part of the game. But the weather did have a big effect on the entire ball game, the win. And I thought we handled it really well.
Well, you actually, I thought you had a field goal with the win at your back there early, which would have given you a 10-7 lead. That was called off. Now that you've had a chance to look back, we were told there was an illegal formation. Was there an illegal formation there?
Yeah, one of our linemen in our PAT field goal formation was a little back. You know, and I was always, you know, told that you're supposed to get a warning with that. You're supposed to, you know, hey, make sure he's up on the line. But it was called immediately and took points off the board. And, again, it's one of those instances where I don't know if that had an effect on the play.
Mm-hmm.
And it was called. And I wonder sometimes if things aren't called, it don't affect the play, it affect the game.
Understand. We were just confused. I mean, it was we weren't really sure. And we checked with a lot of folks up in the press box, and nobody could really find out there. You had Kyrie Hawkins didn't get the CA Player of the Week from a defensive standpoint, but he was your Defensive Player of the Week. 17 tackles, and he had a pretty good ball game. One slip up we know about, missing an assignment there or missing an alignment.
Right.
But how do you think that he played as well as – there were many times I think he was closing in on gaps that were open there.
Well, he did a nice job. I thought his alignment and assignment for most of the ball game was really good. The thing I'll say about our entire defense is we played extremely hard. And I felt like we got three turnovers because we were hustling to the ball.
Mm-hmm.
And that was something that in weeks past, there have been the balls that have been there that we haven't gotten. We got them this week. And that was really important for us. But Kyrie had an unbelievable day of one, being able to get himself in position to make plays. Well, which was good.
Yeah, well, I think he actually jarred the one loose that Raven Green did get the recovery on. So a good good situation there. And the defensive line may have actually, even though you look at the numbers, had a pretty good game all in all, although you did lose Evan Asuji, who had six tackles on Saturday.
Right, right. We lose Evan for the week, and don't know how long after that, but Evan played really well for us up front. And I felt like our line did a nice job of not really getting knocked off the ball. There was a lot of gap scheme runs, so they were able to hold our gaps. And we actually moved a little bit more up front. And some guys make plays, so that was good for us to have our D-line be more productive in that aspect of the game.
So, Coach, second straight year, the Dukes have at least eight wins, and the eighth win is an important win in the FCS, and that's kind of one checked off your list. Now you go on and try to get win number nine.
No question. You know, anytime you can get eight is good. You know, I always say, you know, when you're playing, you don't really count and know how many wins you're going to get, but that eighth one always feels good when you get it, and obviously at the FCS level, it's big. It, you know, gives you an opportunity to at least start thinking maybe you got a playoff shot. So,
right.
And then we'll move on from there and try to get number nine.
All right. Congratulations
Thank
on
you.
The victory over Delaware. Last time the Dukes won in Delaware was 2009. As the Dukes do improve to 8-2, 5-2 in the CA, they still have a chance at maybe tying for the regular season title. We'll be back with more here on the Everett Withers Show after this timeout.
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep a rebate. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24/7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
We buy right so you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much
more. All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products, we buy right so you can
too. Office Products, we do things right.
Clear to zip. Break a little. That's good. Good job. Game on.
Welcome to Valley Building Supply of Harrisonburg, formerly known as Valley Blocks. We've combined with the Valley Building Supply chain to offer a wider range of products and services to our customers. Visit our newly remodeled showroom to see the latest from Anderson. We also carry interior and exterior doors in a variety of styles and finishes, and custom hardwood flooring and moldings. We are your Shenandoah Valley Masonry experts. Our expanded inventory now includes more tools and builder's hardware than ever before. Let Valley Building Supply show you how to create the home of your dreams from foundation to finish.
JMU Nation, how you doing? This is Coach Cisa of your JMU Dukes defensive coordinator and inside linebacker coach. I wanted to talk to you today, kind of show you the most critical play of our defensive season up against Delaware on Saturday. Really exciting game. Came down to this final play for the defense to give our offense one last shot. And as you kind of look at the screen just to set up the situation, there were 2 minutes left in the game. Third down and four, we had no timeouts left, which basically meant if we did not get this stop, that Delaware would have been able to run the clock out. So as we kind of take a look at this formation, this we anticipated they had some success with a quarterback run early in the game out of this exact formation. And so we anticipated before they broke the huddle that this was going to be the play that they came to. So what we wanted to do was to bring pressure from the field side to try to flood all of our players into the boundary. To keep the quarterback from getting any kind of easy run or clean run. So what you'll see, as you see this set up, you'll see the players working to the boundary. You'll see Justin Wellens blitzing off the top. And you'll see the D-line all working to the boundary. So we were anticipating this play. They gave us this play. Really good job right here by Kyrie Hawkins of bubbling the ball and giving Andrew Anker a chance to make the play. Doesn't quite finish, but you see Brandon Herford really screaming from the backside. Beats a block, comes and smacks the quarterback. We're hoping that was going to be the last part of it, but thankfully Raven Green was coming from the high safety position to come and clean it up and really be able to stop them and force a fourth and two where they had to make a decision and ultimately punt the ball. So as you take a look at the back shot again, you'll see the D-line all moving towards the play. We've got everybody going in that direction. We build a wall and bubble. And then what you'll see again, you'll see Brandon Herford come in with a great hit, and then Raven Green come to clean it up to keep him short from getting the first down. Again, really critical play for us as a defense this season. Really excited to see our guys finish the game strong and hopefully looking forward to another great performance against Villanova to finish out the home regular season on Saturday. Thank you guys again for all your support, and go Dukes, and turn this over to the offense. Thank you.
All right, thanks, Coach Sisa. It's Coach Elliott here talking about our last play of the game winner, 17 seconds to go. If you look on the board here, this is the same exact play we ran against SMU to win the game. A little different defense. So we were anticipating kind of a cover zero look. They ended up going basically what we call two-man, which is man underneath, and then two safeties over the top. What we're trying to do is run two ends right here in a corner route. That's the one we hit John Miller on against SMU. But they didn't have a safety back there. So Brian, we called this, Brian saw the safety back there and immediately knows he needs to work the fade route to Ravenel, trying to really beat the safety. If you look at as we play it here, safety doesn't do a great job of getting over the top, which helps us out. Brian does a good job initially holding with his eyes, and he knows he's got a one-on-one opportunity with Ravenel here to the boundary. Does a great job of just giving a catchable ball. And then Rav finishes it by going up and attacking it at its high point. This is also what we call a back shoulder fade. A lot of times on fades, you try to win to the back pylon. If we tell the quarterbacks that the DB is getting over the top and winning, throw that thing at the back shoulder of the receiver, he'll stop and go get it. And you can see here pretty good protection. Holding up, allowing Brian time. You can see his eyes here doing a good job of holding that safety. And getting back, finding the receiver. Making a play. So that was our game-winning play against Delaware. And thanks for joining us, and see you next week.
Thank you very much, coaches, as we take a look with a little chalk talk here on the Coach Everett Withers Show. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we'll actually have on set the JMU Special Teams Player of the Week, Gunnar Kane, after this timeout on the Everett Withers Show. Yay! Yay!
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep the rebates. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24/7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
Welcome to Valley Building Supply of Harrisonburg, formerly known as Valley Blocks. We've combined with the Valley Building Supply Chain to offer a wider range of products and services to our customers. Visit our newly remodeled showroom to see the latest from Anderson. We also carry interior and exterior doors in a variety of styles and finishes, and custom hardwood flooring and moldings. We are your Shenandoah Valley Masonry experts. Our expanded inventory now includes more tools and builder's hardware than ever before. Let Valley Building Supply show you how to create the home of your dreams from foundation to finish.
Products. We buy right so you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products. We buy right so you can.
right.
Clear to zip.
Break a little. Touchdown. Very good job. Game on.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Coach Everett Withers Show. Once again, I'm Kurt Dudley, and we have on our set today a special guest. He is the Special Teams Player of the Week for the Dukes this week, and that is Gunnar Kane, the punter. Redshirt junior from Virginia Beach, went to Kellam High School, a former Knight. We'll check in with the former quarterback as well, I understand. Before we get to that, though, Gunnar, last week, what a fabulous performance for you. As special teams was the key to field position last week.
Yes, sir.
And you had to go through a lot of pregame routine to kind of gauge how you're going to kick the ball last weekend.
Yes, sir. It gets a little windy around here in Harrisonburg, but definitely not 20 to 30 mile an hour winds. So when we got there, I knew I had to really go out and just kind of gauge how was I going to, you know, get the ball accurate, get it to where I wanted it to go. And I really felt like getting that low line drive, no hang time, was the best way. Not to mention at the beginning of the game, I saw the first kickoff. It was kicked and it hung up there and it was really short because the wind just caught it dead. And so I made a really good point to keep the ball real low and it seemed to work. So
you know, that's interesting that you say that because, you know, you've only punted 31 times this season.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yeah. Which isn't a lot for 10 games in a year. I mean,
I think I have about half the punts I did last year. I had like 60-some punts.
Okay.
I think I'm about half right now.
And you're in a situation where the less we see you, actually, the better it is. I mean,
no doubt, that's the type
of position.
No doubt.
So the reason I'm saying that is because you're on the sideline a lot to come in for a very short period of time. Yet you have to stay mentally engaged in the game. Can you tell us how you do that? One, I mean, you're making the observation on the kickoff about how the wind's going.
Right.
It's like you're throwing grass up that is, try to get it out of here, grass up into the air to kind of to test what's going on. How do you gauge that then?
Nonstop on the sideline. A big part of it is a long snapper, Derek Hart. He's always, you know, getting me, hey, let's take some snaps. Hey, do some drops. You know, he's always like, we got to stay in the flow of things. Maybe get on the bike for, you know, a couple minutes here. Just always going to kick a little bit, do this, that, never just sitting and staying content with what's going on. So we're always doing something to make sure we're ready to go when we get out there.
When you make a punt stick, sometimes we'll make a golf reference that you pulled out a certain club.
Yeah.
Do you do any golfing?
I'm pretty bad at golfing, to be honest. Yeah, not gonna lie.
But to that same theory there, though, you've got a variety of kicks that you can basically employ, it looks like.
Yeah, it's I guess it all depends on the situation, where we are in the field, you know, the wind, if we're backed up, you know, like against William and Mary, you know, when they're coming, you know, the coaches kind of say, just get the ball out.
Right.
We don't care what happens, just get the ball out. And so, you know, it definitely, there's a lot of different situations.
Former quarterback for the Knights, when did you start punting, though?
I punted freshman year of high school and then stopped because we had a really good kicker and all that. And then senior year, there's nobody to kick, and I was like, sounds fun, why not?
So. All right, you get another chance to punt for the Dukes today, or make that Saturday against the Villanova Wildcats. That's Gunnar Kane, redshirt junior, punter for the Dukes of JMU. We'll come back and we'll take a look at the Villanova Wildcats with Coach Withers after this timeout on the Coach Everett Withers Show.
Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep the rebates. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24/7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
Welcome to Valley Building Supply of Harrisonburg, formerly known as Valley Blocks. We've combined with the Valley Building Supply chain to offer a wider range of products and services to our customers. Visit our newly remodeled showroom to see the latest from Anderson. We also carry interior and exterior doors in a variety of styles and finishes, and custom hardwood flooring and moldings. We are your Shenandoah Valley Masonry experts. Our expanded inventory now includes more tools and builder's hardware than ever before. Let Valley Building Supply show you how to create the home of your dreams from foundation to finish.
Products. We buy right so you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products. We buy right so you can too.
Office Products. We do things right.
Clear to zip.
Break a little. That's good. Very good job. Game on.
Welcome back, everyone. We welcome back in the Dukes head coach, Everett Withers. The Dukes are 8-2, going for win number 9 this Saturday. Let's spend a moment or so talking about the Villanova Wildcats. This game, even before the season started, a lot of fans were circling just because you had two great quarterbacks going at each other. The dynamics of this have totally changed now, but it's still an extremely important game for both teams.
Yeah, no question. Villanova's playing as good as anybody in this league right now, and Coach Talley, who's a long time coach in this league, has done an unbelievable job of replacing his quarterback and John Roberts and putting in a young man I think is playing as good as any quarterback in the league also. So, and they're playing really good on defense. There's a lot to play for. There's playoff implications. There's championship implications. There's a lot of things that go on in this game, but it's just really about being two really good teams, I think, that are going to play a really good game this week.
Yeah, I expect it to be a really good contest at Bridgeport Stadium. Before that, you'll recognize a senior class of 10 members here. And, you're a second-year head coach. You come in. You have players that you inherit.
Right.
How has this class kind of helped you to establish the culture you want to establish?
Well, a little bit different than last year's 2014 class. This class has had another year under its belt with the culture. And I think now they kind of bought in and believe it. And they're able to go out and speak it. And to me, that's the big thing, is to be able to go out and speak your culture to your younger players and to the people out in the JMU community so they understand exactly what JMU football is about. So I'm really proud of this group.
Yeah, they've done an excellent job, I think, of representing the university. Another team that's going to represent JMU in the CA playoffs coming up, Coach. We've got actually the CA Volleyball Championships here this weekend as the Dukes emerged as the number one seed. Now, they ended up in a four-way tie in the CAA. We're looking for maybe a tie, multiple teams in the CAA, but nice to have another team having a great fall season.
Yeah, our fall sports been unbelievable here. Field hockey, volleyball, it's been an unbelievable year. So our soccer has been really good here. So good luck to our women. I think they're going to do a good job.
They are as well. So we're after the ball game. The JMU Volleyball Dukes will be on the floor at 5 o'clock at Godwin Hall. That'll do it this week for the Coach Everett Withers Show. As the Dukes host the Villanova Wildcats again, kickoff is at noon at Bridgeport Stadium. For head coach Everett Withers, I'm Kurt Dudley. Have a great week.